Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Today's episode of the Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by our bonus packages. Please go to MikeO'MaraShow.com and click on the bonus banner. You'll get access to all of our bonus content, and even better, you'll be helping out TMOS. So please, quit sucking, and we thank you.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Nah, I don't like it.
No?
Oh, yeah, this is it.
That's better.
Inauguration Day 2021. Let me try the other one. Hold on a second.
Oh, yeah.
No, it's standard. That's, you know.
You're right. Can I suggest one?
No.
Okay. Oh.
You know, it might be a good time for me. Have I debuted my Brian Williams impersonation?
Oh, I don't think so.
I don't think we've ever spotlighted
it. No.
All right, here we go.
Sun rising on the Capitol, our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., as President-elect Joe Biden is attending a church service. The words of Maya Angelou.
Strong.
Thank you.
Love it. Yeah,
You know, I don't know. Sometimes I have them and I do them for my own amusement, and I just don't do them regularly.
And this was a physical one.
Yeah, I love when you.
But
really
you know what? I don't have to do that. I can do it like this. The real Brian Williams. That was an exaggerated Brian Williams.
Right.
The real Brian Williams would be.
It is Inauguration Day, as we. But no, it works better with a. Inauguration Day, as we gather together, I'm here with Nicole Wallace and the Rachel Maddow and the entire MSNBC news team as we are gathering to experience the non-peaceful transition of power.
Anyway, that's it.
Mr. Williams.
I love when it's a physical one, though, because there are certain ones that you're fun to watch do.
Mr. Williams, why the 11th hour?
Yes, Oscar.
Why the 11th hour? I always wondered that.
The 11th hour.
Yes.
It's an expression, and I thought it would be a clever way of...
A what way?
A clever. It would be a clever way of doing the naming the show. That's why you named it.
Are you doing... Like, 7 o'clock news at 11 o'clock.
I'm doing my morning show at night.
Hey, B Dubs, I got a question.
I'm hearing that skip back that you have on your computer that
B-Dubs,
we normally discover prior to the show. But it might not be you. It could be any one of us. That's the way it goes. Number nine. It's gone. It's gone like magic. You pressed a button and it worked. That's fantastic.
Do you think the Tiger King? Joe Exotic will be pardoned.
Joe Exotic will not be pardoned as of midnight last night. Only Lil Wayne can claim that fantastic.
And Steve
anyway,
Bannon.
And Steve Bannon. Here we are, January 20th, 2021.
Yes.
Our show originates from the nation's capital. I am down here in Florida, but our main operation is in D.C., in the confines of D.C., locked down D.C., and... I have said, and I think you could probably go back and find it on previous shows, either on the radio, on the podcast, whenever, that I have talked about, even when my team loses, right. That I've always admired. I remember one of George W. Bush's inaugurations. It was so cool, and I watched his inauguration, even though I really wanted him to lose. And I said, you know, at the end of the day, I remember watching that. As somebody from the opposition and watching that and saying to myself, you know, that made me feel peaceful. It really did.
Yes.
It was like, and so for those that are frustrated and childlike in there, for example, I posted last night about the memorial and that I felt hopeful. It was a very brief post. Inundated with the trolls, the guys that just were not either taught by their fathers.
A memorial post.
Let me bring it up.
I know.
Let me share it with you.
I thought that was the most presidential thing I've seen in 4 years.
I saw that you posted it, and I jumped on, and I said, this is such a beautiful cleansing moment for our country. It was just remarkable.
Well, I think it was really brief, and it was very overdue for 400,000 Americans that have lost their lives due to COVID. And I just really didn't. Sometimes I'm completely blindsided because I don't expect it to be something that will elicit it. But I have to remember, you have to remember that this this president has kind of set an example for how to be a sore loser.
Yeah. Yeah.
And, you know, it's funny when I would slam this president all the time and I would slam other presidents. I would make a comment here, but then there's a time and a place. So when I got online last night and decided to post this, I didn't expect anything. I wrote this simple sentence, a long overdue memorial for those we have lost due to COVID-19. I feel hopeful.
Yeah.
That's it. That's what I wrote. And this guy, Scott Shorter, writes to me, where's the memorial for all the victims of car accidents? Where's the long overdue memorial for all the victims of heart disease?
That's when you got to go.
What? Is there some, have I, you know, have I, is there something that I, my inability to understand that is my inability to reach out to the other side? Because I don't get that. I find that response childlike.
Yeah.
And only tone deaf, but just more childlike than anything else.
It's
that's
the sign of the mental midget.
Right, but it's just so, it's so. Because
they try to equate a pandemic.
I said, but by the way, this particular comment, more than I've written more controversial things.
Yeah, you have.
Slamming this president on my feed.
All the things you said about Elvis.
Yes. Why, you hate the Beatles?
So I said, I'm feeling hopeful. Brian Randolph writes, I'm glad someone is.
Yeah.
There's this hate coming
hate
out.
People.
Is there, you know, Michael Wysong writes,
oh,
meh.
Man names. I love
meh.
It.
Meh. Okay. I guess meh. That it's a long overdue memorial for people. Meh means you don't believe we should memorialize the people that have died, Michael. Is that what it is? It's just stunning to me. It really, really is. Mm. You know, I don't understand it. And I just don't. I understand you're mad that your man lost. But at the same time, the question to you guys,
yes,
as we are really violating one of the great traditions of American democracy.
Yeah, it's real time.
Do you think this reaction, people with that feel, in years past probably would not have had the balls to do that because they wouldn't think it was appropriate, but now let their inner child, their inner toddler that has to win or no one else can win, their inner infant go through on these. So do you think that's because of where we are now? And where we are with their fearless leader who showed them that, hey, you can be just like me, a complete and total asshole, and it'll be acceptable socially.
Yeah.
It just,
I think it cuts both ways, Mike, where there's a reckoning coming for this type of rhetoric. Not people's opinions. Look, you're entitled to your opinion. You can do whatever you want. I believe that within the next 4 years, especially for these social media platforms that tolerated under the First Amendment banner of free speech, that you want to succeed, you want to grow, you want to basically outwit and outperform what our current legal system does for the better part of a decade almost. Now we're going to put you on an even footing with newspapers and television stations, because you have to be held accountable for what is out there and what is on your platform, especially if they're lies. And I believe within the next 4 years, we'll have seen that reckoning coming. The same man, Donald Trump, that helped a lot of these platforms grow exponentially in the last 4 years, is going to help take them down. Because he set the standard, and it's going to show a lot of people in the long run what you can and cannot do. And if just because you build it doesn't mean you're not accountable for what's on it.
Well, it is, this morning I watched, a lot of television today as far as the show. And here's a moment, as we speak, Republicans and Democrats are at a church service prior to the inauguration at Biden's Catholic Church in Washington, D.C. And one tiny little detail emerged from what happened today. And I don't care what team you're on. The president, who is not acknowledging, is not attending the inauguration,
right,
was leaving prior to that on Air Force Marine One and then flying to Andrews Airport, Air Force Base, where he gave a speech, boarded Air Force One. He's now in the air heading down to Mar-a-Lago with no mention of Biden in his speech at Andrews. And then the news reported that while he was giving that speech, Joe Biden purposefully delayed leaving for the church to let Trump complete his goodbye speech. Yeah. That should tell you all you need to know about, you know, the classy move that we're getting right now. And whether you agree with his politics or not, I just hope it is a new day. And I feel like it might be a new day, because when I was on the opposite side and I was sad that George W. Bush had won the presidency, I remember watching it. And I think I said something to the effect of, I couldn't tear myself away from it. Yeah. It's something where it is so American because it so involves opposition parties, and they're on this dais together, that I watched that. And today, unfortunately, I believe that a lot of people will be ignoring the inauguration because their team didn't win, when I still think it's a great tradition. I'm glad that Vice President Mike Pence will be at the inauguration. At least someone will be there. I'm glad that Joe Biden invited Mitch McConnell and Kevin McCarthy to the church service prior to that. So I have to be hopeful, but there is so much hatred out there right now. So much hatred that still exists, and we're divided. And it's just but I still think I can be hopeful. I don't think there's anything wrong with, with being hopeful.
Today feels like New Year's.
Yeah, well, today
feels like New Year's more than anything else. Today,
Mike, no one would ever say anything other than the fact that you are the biggest political junkie on the show by far.
So true.
And you've said a lot of wise things through the years, and I sort of follow what you say. And I think one of the greatest things you said is that the peaceful transfer of power is the hallmark of our nation, and it truly is.
It is that inauguration ceremony to me is no. There is no better example of what democracy is all about.
I love it.
I've always thought that. I love the pomp and circumstance with that. Today, it's been tainted.
Yeah.
And it's been tainted by one guy. And you know what? It's going to go on, and it's still, I'm going to watch the whole thing, and it's going to be beautiful to watch.
Yep.
But make no mistake, one guy made a concerted effort because of his ego to screw it up. And that's sad to me. That really is sad.
So, for example, in my eyes, the way I felt, and the reason why I said it feels like New Year's, is because this is the first time I've been hopeful. Look, I like New Year's Eve and the idea that you can spend it with your family or your loved ones, and you get to call everybody, and you didn't get to see anybody this year because of COVID. But this is the first time in the morning when I saw that chopper lift off from the South Lawn, Marine One. I was like, oh, thank goodness.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Collective sigh of relief. You know, it's funny.
You start thinking about all
the
lasts. You think about all the lasts. That's the last time he's going to get on that chopper.
Here's another one that was on my thread from Jimmy Hoffman, who's not a friend of mine. Really nice guy. Maybe he was a friend. I blocked him, I think. Jimmy Hoffman, the irony of Biden and a memorial is not lost in the moment. Ha, ha, ha. Yeah, because Biden's going old. You know, the other guy's not old, but Biden's old. I'm saddened that he will not know that he attended the event. You know, dude, that's fine. I know you're mad. I know you're mad that your man didn't win, but you're demonstrating how little class you have.
We also, I would say, listen to. So we get to read this real time and listen to you, Mike. Get us, you know, really give us the framework of the way people are responding to what is a post for hope, not even a political post from your end,
right?
And the idea that someone would even take the time to even respond in that manner, like, I would say to those gentlemen and ladies, whoever may be on there, like, take a beat. Like, first off, we're a radio show and podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is where you're going to put your energies in.
Well, I would also say that when you're talking about compassion for the people that have been lost during this pandemic, we've talked about how it is so. It has so been reduced to a number for the entire length of this pandemic. And that's not just any administration's fault. That's the way we have processed it in the United States. You know, certain news outlets do a little mention of a particular individual that has passed due to COVID. But the scale of it and to take that moment to do that is something that should not be a partisan situation at all.
No.
But it has been turned into one. And I would say to somebody who wants to make a flip comment and diminish the president whose administration, the president-elect, whose people were responsible for putting that together, what you have to do is you got to take a good, hard look in that mirror. You have to realize that, look, I don't think that showing compassion is soft. I don't think that showing compassion is weak. I think showing compassion is, in many cases, necessary to heal and heal where we are. And it really, really is. I don't doubt for one second that there is corruption in a Democratic administration, that there are terrible mistakes made in a Democratic administration, that Democrats can screw up, that Democrats can be criminals, that it's all true. What I'm saying, though, is when there is a moment that is something that we all should be behind, and you show absolute, not disregard for what I wrote, disregard for the idea of having a memorial to 400,000 plus people. You got to really think about it and think about how your hatred and your anger and your bitterness, or maybe the way you were raised, has not allowed you to open that part of your heart and just give them a nod. It's it's one thing to be pissed, but then you got to comment on it on a thread where I'm just putting up a thread there saying, hey, this was a pretty cool move. I said nothing political during that other than feeling hopeful. If that's being political, I am political. I get that. But we got a long way to go. We got a long way to go to calm down. I don't know if we're ever going to get there. I don't know if we're ever going to be doing the damage. I think it'll be interesting to watch today and to see where we are. But pretty stunning to realize there won't be a human being on that mall on Inauguration Day. And Inauguration Day, I've been to two of them. I've waded through them with my dear friend Jimmy Cerito.
By land and by water,
and by sea.
Yeah.
By land and by water. We went through that. So at the end of the day, I just, do I want to raise my fist up in the air and go, I'm probably in private moments I'm doing that. But I also, am just taking this little toll of keeping score of all these moments, like, yielding to the sitting president as he gave a farewell speech where he didn't mention the incoming president and waiting to go to church so that would conclude. And I just went, man, talk about just an advertisement for being the bigger person, for being the grown up, for being the grown up in the room. I just, was a good thing. And I want to, I will refrain from saying what I said when I saw Air Force One in the air. When I said, don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out. I just, I couldn't help myself.
They used to say that on when they take off on Pan Am Airlines. That was actually what they would say in the in-flight PA system.
But, you don't pay attention to the little details. Little details like when I'm watching President Trump's helicopter land on the lawn of the White House, that there are three little paved squares where that Marine pilot puts down that massive helicopter
every time.
He nails it.
Yeah.
It's just got to inch it a little bit forward right at the end there. But it's just the pomp and circumstance and ceremonial stuff is pretty pretty special. Now, I want to ask you about this at the front of the show, Oscar. I know we put it at the end of the prep today, but I have to ask you about what it's like now, because Rob's still in Leesburg because we have a COVID protocol at Podcast Village. What is it like in D.C., which appears to be somewhat of a ghost town today?
Note to self, for those of you that are industrious and say, you know what, I'm going to go to work every day and I'm going to make sure that I make a statement, and doesn't matter if it's a national holiday or the town is in a full security mode and they say, if you can stay home, stay home. When you decide to go to work, don't dress like you're dressing for some sort of insurgency.
We were commenting on Oscar's outfit today where if I'm glancing at Oscar very quickly with all of the patches and all of the symbols, even though one of them I believe is BMW,
yes.
I would sit there and go,
Are you trying to appear to be a Special Forces impersonator? Because I think you're going to get a zip tie around your wrists and you're going to be tackled by the Secret Service.
A lot of my clothes is... Sports Douchey. And...
Is he still on Fox News,
it's
Mike?
It's the best way to
Sports
do
Douchey with you. How you doing? I'll tell you that, Tom Brady. I got some tape here. Tom Brady and Drew Brees having a little family moment. Sports Douchey with you.
So, by design, whether it's a Nike jacket or Under Armour, it looks like you're going to some sort of tactical event because, you know, if...
Well, are you, I mean, when you're walking around your neighborhood in Georgetown, are you coming across... any Popo or National Guard?
More
or
so
anybody?
Than I've ever seen.
But really?
But yes.
Even in your neighborhood, which is far away from all the stuff.
Yes. Especially because M Street is closed down coming into the city up to one lane. And there's just a heavy police presence right next to the Key Bridge. And for me going downtown yesterday, I remember getting up and I said, okay, don't dress Sports Douchey or too flamboyant. Blend in. So I wore gray... a gray, collared shirt, a gray pants, and I wore my red sneakers, which I felt screamed like, I'm not a threat. I'm just Sports Douchey, right? In some way. And then the jacket that I picked out, because it was chilly, it is winter here, was an Under Armour.
Very chilly in D.C. today, very cold. Very windy.
Under Armour pullover that I was wearing, if you watched yesterday's show, which I didn't realize, is not white. It looks like it almost has tactical little graphics on it.
If I'm glancing at that, you look like you're a police officer.
Yeah, or I'm trying to dress like one.
And you also look like you might be wearing like a Kevlar vest.
Could be.
Under that.
Could be.
You know?
So I park.
That you could have stolen from an unattended police car.
A block away.
Right.
From the building downtown we're on at 1900 M Street. And I'm like, I kind of look like I'm here for something that I'm not. I'm just going to the office. But I always was self-aware. So I said, hands out of pockets. The FBI building I walk by and the ATF building.
How many cops have you bumped into? Have you been checked out by anybody?
So I was stopped.
You were?
Yes.
No way.
I was stopped.
Of course you were.
As I should have been.
Of course you were.
As I should have been.
Don't need you for a minute, sir.
I was stopped not walking into the building, but leaving the building back to my car last night. Stopped in front of the ATF building as an officer walked up to me, sir, may I help you? Because I was walking with my hands in my pockets like this. Because
it was cold,
with
probably.
With my backpack. Yeah. And I didn't know. I was like, you got to keep your hands out, right?
Right.
So two guys walked up to me and they said, can I help you? I was like, oh, that's my garage right next to your building. And they said, the garage is closed. And they said, no, I have a fob to get me in. I know it's closed today. And then they said, do you mind taking your hands out of your pocket? And they weren't arresting me. It was just the sheer, like, stop and frisk. I'm sure they had in NYC years ago where I was like...
Hold on a second. We have breaking news. And all the news updates I will do in my Brian Williams impression.
Good,
today,
thank you.
Right? President Donald Trump has followed at least one presidential tradition. The White House says the Republican president left behind a note for his successor, Joe Biden. That's good, though. That's good. I like that. I think he deserves credit. But Obama left Trump a note, and if he's not going to go to the inauguration, he's going to violate something. At least that is, I, of course,
would love that note to be scanned in the software that teachers use for any sort of, any sort. What is the term when someone uses somebody else's work?
Oh,
plagiarism.
Plagiarism, yes.
Well, I think that it's good. I hope we, and you know what? We may never know what was in the note because Biden might not reveal it.
I see here the note was only two words.
Second word off. I would die to know. And by the way, all that stuff I hold on to. I think that's the kind of day this is. You have to be positive. Back to you getting stop and frisk.
Just briefly, this from the peanut gallery, I think this is worth it. Pony writes, it's a picture note.
That's it. Oh, my God.
So they stop me. And it's roughly 6:30, so it's dark out. I get it. And I said, I understand. I look like I'm trying to do something. I'm just trying to get to my car. I said that to the cop. I said I wore the wrong jacket. This is the wrong jacket.
What did the cop say to you?
He started laughing. He's like, do you mind if we take a look at your backpack? And I said, no problem. Like it literally was the first time in DC.
Why are you wearing a backpack, for Christ's sake? That's dangerous too. Are you trying to get tackled? Is that what you're trying to do?
I told my wife, I said, when am I going to stop pretending like I'm 25?
What's in the backpack, sir? It's just a pressure cooker that I'm taking to my mom's house.
My backpack looks like I have a pressure cooker in it because
Look at that backpack. Come on. What are you doing? So they look in your backpack. Yeah. What is in there, by the way?
Oh, you want snacks.
Yeah.
Are you kidding? Is it Wanda Farmer Snacks? Is that what it is? Hi, Wanda. How are you?
Hello. Hello.
Is it Wanda Farmer Snacks?
I've got computers, chargers, meds, all kinds of stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Wires.
Wires.
Oh, God.
That's right.
You're a mallet head.
Let me check your search history. What does .ru mean?
So... I felt, and usually I'm like, oh man, this profiling and all this BS. And you know me, I'm not like the Raza guy, but I just am racially ambiguous at times, profile wise.
This is why we love you.
And the beard.
I shot Raza in the Aza.
And the beard doesn't help. And right. I said, thank you for your service. I don't know if that's what you're supposed to say. I was like, I'm sure this is the last thing you want to deal with. And I think right away they got it, that I wasn't a threat. But if you're stopping random people with backpacks that look like they're going to do something, I'm for it, especially in front of a federal building. I'm for
it. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they just let me on my way.
I knock on wood that there will never be tighter security in our nation's capital.
Quick sidebar?
Yes.
I am profiling all the time when I'm down there, ever vigilant.
It's a different kind of profiling, right?
If
you're going into an airport and I see a guy that looks like Larry the Cable Guy, I'm saying to myself, I'm worried about this guy, but I don't think that's the chip. I don't think you
But the CIA has issued a statement that the most dangerous place to be right now is at a Jeff Foxworthy show.
You know what the tell is? If you're not running around town and you're not exercising, is when you don't have one of these on and you're just going around just doing your business and you're like,
yeah.
I mean, this is a mask city.
I'm going to be as optimistic as I can. Are we shell-shocked from the January 6th episode? Yeah. Yes, we are. There was a great article I was reading yesterday by a Secret Service, former Secret Service person, talking about the overabundance of security, going beyond what is probably even remotely necessary is the solution to where we are right now. That hopefully will not be the way America is for the rest of our days. I think we will get back to a sense of normalcy. I think it is inevitable. You want some hopeful messaging here? I think the rhetoric will be toned down. Right now it's at a fever pitch.
God willing.
Yep.
God willing it will be. And you know what? On both teams, I hope that we have a better discourse going forward. And I hope this is an aberration. I have only one fear. And when he makes comments like, we may see you
again. I'll
be
back soon.
That's in some form or another.
The idea that Ivanka Trump may run against Rubio in Florida and then make her track to the White House.
Yeah.
But you're like,
it's a little strange.
He didn't do much over there.
I don't know. It's a big name. It's a big, big name. So, I don't know. But really, try to get just a little, gentle tan jacket to walk
around. I know.
Right.
Are you kidding me? I said, Shannon,
sucker suit.
I'm going to stop by the house before I go back downtown because she's downtown. Today.
You know, really, the way you look and the way Robb looks, if both of you were walking down the street, I'd profile Robb before I profile you right now, the way things are going. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no.
But
my
backpack isn't full of nails. I'm fine.
How dare you? That is not a good joke.
You're right.
I said, Shannon,
stop writing those jokes.
Will you find the most boring outfit and lay it out for me? Because I clearly don't have a good gauge on this.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So she found, I do have a trench coat, not a trench coat.
Well, that's a bad look. An overcoat.
Is it a black trench coat?
No, it's
probably.
It's blue and tailored.
Yeah, Mike, it's the one we got him for Christmas one year. Remember? We chipped in, we got him an overcoat.
You got me an Uncle Buck coat, and that went right back.
No, do you still have your Uncle Buck coat, Robb?
Yeah, I still wear it. Absolutely.
The gray one?
It's brownish gray. I'll get it so you can see. It's sort of a tweed. Hold on.
This is Rob's coat. This is Rob's
6XL overcoat.
Maddie, have you seen this coat yet?
Have you seen this coat?
Oh my God. I haven't.
Oh, this is the coat. This is Rob's overcoat.
This is the
fattest piece of clothing he owns. Barna. There
is. And you misspoke,
Rob could gain 80 pounds right? And still fit into that easily, right?
It is the greatest coat ever. It is thinsulate. It is down past almost to my ankles. So on a windy day, it protects you. And it was really cheap. I think it was $28.
So $28? How many years ago did you get it?
This has got to be 15 years
old. Where do you wear that?
I like to get naked and put it on.
Do you have a brand
name? Only do
name
one button.
Does it have a brand name?
It's Eddie Bauer. It was an Eddie Bauer.
Oh, it's an Eddie Bauer.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Aren't they out of business?
A lot of mall stores are, Oscar. There's a pandemic going on.
Look at the pattern.
Oh,
see there.
So
now you
great.
Get a good look at the pattern.
It is
there.
So great.
Is
I love
is
it.
Is that, by the way, is that a button on the top up there, like on your lapel? Is that
yeah,
a button?
I could button it all the way up.
Oh, look at that. You haven't gained that much weight.
Hey, Gomez, look, it's me, Uncle Fester.
It's Uncle Fester. Now you
it's
can
my
start
Uncle
the
Fester coat.
That's Uncle Fester. It's a re.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
Everybody. It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mike O'Mara, Rob Spiewak, Oscar Santana.
And now, from his easy chair, here's Mike.
We are live from the Podcast Village Studios from Washington, D.C. This is the Mike O'Mara Show, a radio show and podcast with a loyal legion of listeners who are part of our family and who listen every day in every corner of the world. This is TMOS, heard in great places like Roseburg, Oregon, Salva, North Carolina, Hurricane, Utah, Gallup, New Mexico, Hammondsport, New York, and Kotka, Finland. The Mike O'Mara Show is on now and brought to you by Cornerstone. The 10-year Treasury, which dictates interest rates, recently rose to pre-COVID levels, causing concern over the future of mortgage lending rates. Now, that might sound complicated. What that means is rates are really, really low to get a great loan right now.
Absolutely.
And they're thinking because of certain news things happening, the rates might start to go up again.
Mm.
So the rates are still at a 50-year low. More than half of you haven't jumped off the fence, though, to get a refi. Maybe, you think they'll fall lower. But maybe you don't even know what your current rate is. Don't wait until it's too late.
That would be a grievous error, Mike.
You have to call my good friend Mark Livingstone and his team at Cornerstone First Financial. Do it today. Other companies only posture that they have super low rates, not telling you about their junk fees and origination points. Call the only company that I recommend, Cornerstone First Financial, 202-625-1221 or cornerstonefirst.com. It's not a question of if, but when these rates will go up.
Yes.
Believe me, since Cornerstone is a lender as well as a broker, if they can't do it, nobody can. Pick up the phone and call Cornerstone First Financial, 202-625-1221 or cornerstonefirst.com. Personal attention from application to closing. If we don't do it today, we'll never do it. Let's get right to the mailbag because it's not
Please.
All about us. It's
Hold
about you, people.
You
Did I catch you by
me.
Surprise?
Yeah,
sometimes I like
you.
To throw stuff. I just figured, what the heck? What the heck, everybody? Yeah, I figured we'd do that because, it's a little palate cleanser with
sure.
everything going on. And I don't want to talk all day about how I was embarrassed to be an American for a short period of time today. Anyway, hey, guys, I have messages, a message for Oscar and his mom.
Yes.
I got a pretty nasty burn on my index finger, so I tried the toothpaste cure.
Oh
dear.
No.
Sadly, the toothpaste only became runny and offered no comfort. Since the heat loosened the toothpaste up,
Gross.
I brushed my teeth with my finger. Gross.
Mm.
So as not to waste the toothpaste. How cheap are you? The blister couldn't handle the scrubbing, though. It was just like Fruit Gushers candy. Now I'm really grossed
out.
Minty goodness sprayed all over my mouth. Let the healing begin. Tony Stangert. Thank you, Tony. That's
so no
nasty.
Toothpaste on burns, please.
No.
Right.
Old wives tale.
Boys,
Old
after
tale.
Several days to let the dust settle, the Audio Vault's bearded plumber farts into a PVC pipe is still cracking me up. Robb's little sounds for the win. Do you have that handy? The PVC pipe?
I sent it to you. I thought you were going to.
Yeah, but I already deleted it. It burned quickly, I didn't have it.
I don't have it any longer, no. But
Joe
I'm glad
McLeod.
Glad
Joe, so you you liked it, Joe, but both Robb and I burned on it quickly.
Yes.
It was on and gone. All right. Let's move on to our next letter here. Last month, I celebrated my 46th birthday by giving myself the gift of laughter, a renewal of my TMOS bonus show subscription. Yay!
That's a great gift.
As a sales representative, the Mike O'Mara Show has been my constant companion since the beginning of the show. Even my kids have grown up listening to the show as I drove them to school. I love to hear that.
Yes.
The week after my birthday, my 15-year-old daughter approached me and said that we had to listen to the show together that day. Imagine my surprise when, during the mailbag, my name came up with my birthday wishes from my daughter.
Aww.
The surprise, however, quickly turned to dismay.
Oh, dear.
As my daughter's face fell, as Robb labeled her letter as the most inadequate letter of the week and told her to do better.
I remember this, yes.
Robb, I wouldn't expect this type of hatred towards children from Oscar. I would expect this type of hatred towards children from Oscar, who, as we all know, has a soul full of gadgets. But you? I think that my daughter is due an apology, or I fear you will have lost a young listener. And as you full well know, the children are our future. What say you, Robb? Good day, sir. I said good day. S.A.D., Robert Musgrave of Portland, Oregon. Robb?
I meant no ill will towards the daughter, and I'm very sorry that she feels that way.
So it was a child that was sent. Were you aware that it was a child that was sending
the
letter?
No, but the letter lacked detail. I mean,
there you go again. Now you're doing it again.
I'm sorry that her feelings are hurt, but
well, you've ruined it now. You know what? She's dead. You're dead to her.
No.
What's her name?
Her name, he probably didn't put it in either.
You wouldn't remember. You don't care. You don't remember. You don't care.
Robb's going through a tough time, everybody. He's usually not this mean.
No, you know what?
Listeners.
He doesn't mention the daughter's name.
All
this
right,
isn't
you know what, Robert?
This letter
you're
is
just
inadequate.
Maybe he's
protecting her.
Name.
Maybe he's protecting
my 15-year-old daughter. You still don't want to mention the name.
Yeah.
Robert Musgrave, Muskrat Love. Please send a letter.
Name your name.
With your daughter's name so I can give
apologize.
Her a tribute.
Yeah.
If
as
you can
fact,
be adequate,
hold on, wait,
I can
shut
apologize.
Up. Mouth, stop. Hold on. I want Robert Musgrave to send a letter detailing all the things he loves about his daughter.
There you go.
And I will share it on
there
the
you
show.
Go. There you go. Perfect.
There you go. Thank you very much. Moving right along. This letter may get serious, so please don't read it coming out of an up-tempo record. Can you kill the music, please? Kill it? Thank you. Hate that music anyway. It's just, you know, your soundtracks can be a little overbearing sometimes. I know we like production elements, but I think as I age, I become less enthralled with them. That's
right.
Just me.
I live to please. You know this. I'm a pleaser.
Well, I wouldn't mind something a little more, just a little more modern, you know, a little bit less retro.
Less zany.
Well, that's not zany, really. Is it? Is more of a retro, I would say. Zany.
Like, for
that.
Example, the first sentence of this letter, Robb.
Yes.
Is this letter may get serious. So what music would you perhaps find for this? I think in 2021, I wish for new elements, new music, and for you to practice being more fleet of foot as a sound producer on the Mike O'Mara Show.
Okay. I have the music for this letter. Go ahead.
All right, this letter may get serious, so please don't read it coming out of an up-tempo record.
What would you do if I sang
That is the theme to This Is Us.
No, it's the theme Wonder to Years. Wonder Years, but also it's Joe Cocker hit record long before that.
Right. Yeah, it's a vocal.
So you don't
we
like
need
that.
An instrumental.
All right.
Yeah.
Don't care.
Let's see.
You know what? Silence is golden.
All right. That's
I'll give
a good
you one more.
Too.
I'll give you one more shot.
All right. I need just a moment. All right,
of course you do.
We'll wait.
Go ahead.
This letter may get serious, so please don't read it coming out of an up-tempo record. Please practice. My wife and I met 10 years ago.
Oh, here's This Is Us. I actually have it. See, that's nice.
My wife and I met 10 years ago, 6 months into dating. I hit a rough spot in my life. I lost my job and couldn't pay rent. She took a gamble on this stray dog and invited me to her place. I took classes at the local community college and graduated with an associate's degree. I landed a career job, but the stress and anxiety revealed an alcohol problem.
Hmm.
She buckled in, and I can now proudly say, alcohol no longer controls me.
Good man.
I'm trying to understand that sentence.
She buckled in into the ride.
She stayed with him.
So she got him off alcohol.
Yes.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Still not a good sentence. I started running and finished the Marine Corps Marathon in 2018. My wife and I live a healthy lifestyle that is a world away from the drunken, selfish a-hole that I once was. I owe this woman my life. Mike and Robb, every time you two speak about your daughters, I hear the pride in your voices and words. I never had that pride until I sobered up and understood my stepdaughter. This young lady had zero reasons to like me, and at first I never gave her one. But she opened up her life to let this stranger in. She recently graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Education with a certificate in bilingual Spanish. She is charging to the front line with unmatched motivation and enthusiasm. In my book, that is the very definition of a hero. Mm. I never had feelings like this before. I was nervous about them at first, but now I can't live without them. I am so proud and grateful to be part of their lives. So to Janelle and Caitlin, I love you both with all of my heart, body, and soul. You two have changed my life and given me a front row seat to a bright future with an amazing family. That comes a very heartfelt letter from Jimmy Shanahan, who loves his stepdaughter and his wife very, very much.
Beautiful.
And has made tremendous strides in his life. Jimmy, congratulations on that. We're proud of you as well. Robb, you can get back to whatever music you want. That's old, but that's all right.
Hi, guys.
No, that's I just want more modern music.
Well, I need a moment for that. I don't really skew modern.
Let me try my
own. All right, please.
All right, here we go. Hey, everybody.
That's good.
Hey, guys, regarding your discussion, you can go back to the original
Yes,
music.
Please.
You can
All
do
right.
that.
Back to
okay.
Zane.
All right. Regarding your discussion of the rubes and realtors that make up a...
There we go.
Yeah.
Regarding the your discussion of the rubes and realtors that make up a town council, members of the Leesburg Town Council receive a monthly stipend. Additionally, they are able to participate in the county's health care system at the rate of a part-time employee. In many Virginia localities, council members and board members receive full health insurance. Thought you should know, Del F.
Oh.
So,
I did
you
not know
that,
that
about your town council?
No, I should run.
Is it a town council? Yeah, it's a Leesburg town. The county, Loudoun County, would be the board of supervisors.
Exactly.
Right?
Loudoun, but Leesburg remains its own entity as a town.
So there are perks.
Yeah, there are perks.
Next letter says, I wanted to send a, by the way, have I mentioned top 10 top mailbag this week? Just one of my favorites. I wanted to send a happy birthday to my stepdad, Fred Cole of Carlsbad, California. He was a Don and Mike. This is a classic first of the year mailbag. This is a classic. We're going to start the year off fucking off like we always do. That's what this is. This is the way. That's the way I look at it. I'm
not,
sorry.
Not
just
the,
had to get that.
Not to
had
the
to
listeners,
get that off my
but
chest.
To
Thank
the
you.
Support staff.
I wanted to send a happy birthday to my stepdad, Fred Cole of Carlsbad, California. He was a Don and Mike listener back in the day, and I converted to a new TMO. I converted him to a new TMOS listener. The pack. Put
$20
in.
Money's coming, guys. $20.
I would send him clips of Mike doing Jim Nance. Fred is a huge golfer, and it has paid off for me. He sent me an awesome TMOS sweatshirt and a fruitcake this year. I wanted the guys to wish him a happy birthday because my mom sent out an email saying all they wanted for their birthdays was a donation to a charity. I think Fred should get something for himself. Thanks, guys. Keep up the awesome work. Lauren Mulligan of Leesburg, Virginia. Moving right along, we have another letter here. Happy New Year from your Paisan Pauly. And may I personally thank DeBoss and DeBoys for the laughter and love that you sent out to the P1s with the very hectic and crazy year that 2020 was. Last Tuesday was my 54th birthday. I know that, Pauly. The world knows that. There's no one anywhere that doesn't know that. Which makes it 12 months until I will be retiring from driving the bus. Yay!
Attaboy.
Which was well over 30 years of my life. My request is to have my favorite Hollywood star, Jack Cassidy, talk up Survivor's Eye of the Tiger. And, of course, wish me a happy birthday. Love yous, Paulie. Paul Blair Christine, Staten Island, New York. Well, Paulie, this one's for you. Washington's hit leader, WABA. In Brooklyn, New York, ladies and gentlemen, there's a bus driver. There's a bus driver that likes food just about as much as any human being likes food. He likes it so much that he shares pictures of that food. And as one of his fellow fat men, I have to say, Paulie, keep on keeping on, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Blair Christine, you're a special individual. And I know it's your lovely wife that makes all the food for you. You just keep taking pictures of it. And I humbly request that you label the pictures just in case we don't know what the real food is. So, happy 54th. Happy soon to be retired. Happy everything. I stepped on it. But that fits.
I like that you asked him. The request was to name the dish.
Yes, we need more detail.
Name the dish.
I'm sorry. That's the mailbag. Thank you, Paulie.
Thank you.
I appreciate that. We're going to take a break and come back with more.
I'm so glad
we did that. I'm really, really happy right now. We'll take a break and come back with more fun on the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Truff. I sincerely believe that there's no food that wouldn't improve with the addition of Truff hot sauce. Truff, that's T-R-U-F-F. FF is in flippin' fantastic, a luxury hot sauce that makes every meal 5 stars. I've had it on eggs, fish, chicken, barbecue, you name it. I haven't tried it on panettone yet, but it's not Christmas time anyway, so it doesn't matter. It's great stuff. Truff is crafted with a signature blend of red chili, black truffle, organic agave nectar, and savory spices. Try all their delicious hot sauces, their flagship hot sauce, the Truff Hotter hot sauce, the premium white truffle hot sauce. They're all delicious. It's more than a hot sauce. It's a showstopper! We all love it. See for yourself why Truff is the biggest hot sauce on Instagram and TikTok. And right now, get 10% off site-wide, plus free shipping when you use promo code TMOS at Truff.com. That's 10% off, plus free shipping on everything, including the white Truff VIP box and the wonderful Truff Variety Pack. Just shop at Truff.com. That's T-R-U-F-F. Remember, the FF is in fine flavor. .com and use promo code TMOS. Thank you very much. Very briefly here, I just want to tell you that we had a little bit of a scare over the weekend. One of the great things about moving to the new neighborhood is my son has another 7-year-old that he plays with constantly when he comes home from school. They ride bikes. They watch video games together. They hang out together. Mm-hmm. They hang out in the pool together.
It's the best.
And it's really been a blessing for us that he's got a friend in our neighborhood when we basically lived in, we lived in a casket for a few years.
An old folks neighborhood.
leading up to that. However, my supervisory capacity sometimes is a little diminished due to my advanced age. I sometimes let them go and do their thing. And because they're 7 and they're boys, they can get into stuff. So I would like to take this opportunity to say I'm very sorry to my wife. When she asked where Michael was, I said I thought he was down at Caleb's house when they, in fact, were in our garage. And that is when my wife went out to check on them and saw them both sitting in the garage playing with a box cutter. Hi, everybody. How you doing? I'm Mike Romero. I'm Father of the Year. Yes, sir. And that Michael had a Band-Aid on his hand where he had cut himself, or whether Caleb had cut him with the box cutter. So
it's been said that you and I were part of like one of the last generations that drank from a hose. We were the kids that, you know, would go out and run around all day and only come home when the streetlights came up. And then came the helicopter parent who really over supervises. So I would say probably the best thing is probably to land somewhere in the middle. Not to be a helicopter parent, but also not to let them play with a box cutter.
Well, I got to be honest with you. I do like the freedom of him being able to walk down the street to the neighbor's house. Yes. That's just been blissful. But I just, I think, now why are you looking at me like that? He gets in his bike and rides down.
No, I just.
What?
You're such a better parent than that.
Well, there's a mistake. I'm sorry. I'm not going to be. Standing there what watching them play Legos all day long.
What were you doing when
watching
he was
TV?
And were you able to get to the bottom of who cut who with the box cutter?
I think the neighbor kid cut Michael.
Oh.
But they,
he had the wherewithal to band aid up himself.
No, it wasn't that bad, but it could have been horrible.
Yeah,
it could have been a total disaster.
Chad Ram situation.
Yeah. So this is a short break. So sorry. Sorry. We got to catch up here. So that's it. Yeah. How you doing that board today? Doing all right?
Doing fine.
Okay.
Doing fine.
You
all
right?
Yeah.
You have a late night last night or something?
Not at all.
Anything
not at
going
all.
On?
No.
Right, just checking. I just want to make sure everything's okay.
Yeah.
That's what I'm here for. You weren't playing with a box cutter, were you?
I just got to get a Band-Aid is all.
Okay, very good.
I actually, Mike, you know what? I have a box cutter.
Why do you have a box cutter?
You might need it sometime. This was actually the one I used at Safeway many years ago.
It's an antique.
That's like a turbocharged one.
Oh, this is a great one. See, it's got like a safety guard here. So when you line this part up with the box, you can't cut yourself.
Mm.
And you can open the box that way. I was pretty good with a box cutter.
You've saved it from when you worked at Safeway? That's like 30 years ago.
Yeah, I've got a couple good tools in my desk. Just in case.
Well, when we come back, go through, see if there's anything else interesting in there. Hoarder says what?
Yep.
We'll be right back on the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. I have had my Sleep Number bed for years and years and years, and they give me a very nice commercial to talk to you about it. But I have to tell you from the bottom of my heart, I've never been more pleased with a product for such a length of time in my home that I love. I'm on my second Sleep Number down here in the great state of Florida, and it's fantastic. And did you know that getting the right amount of sleep can help you make healthier decisions in the kitchen?
True.
It can.
Yeah.
A good night's sleep's fantastic. You know, outside of my son coming into the bed at about 2 o'clock in the morning, I had a blissful night's sleep. My Sleep Number was not responsible for my bad night's sleep. My son was.
Sleep Number should sell a lock for your door.
Yeah. That's there was some sort of cough he had, and he's fine, by the way, but it was like... at 2 o'clock in the morning, and my eyes sat bolt upright. But then I was able to get blissfully right back to sleep. Why? Because I have a Sleep Number. A great day starts the night before. That's why not only will I be luxuriating in my Sleep Number bed, but I'll be putting a padlock on our door tonight so that we can have an uninterrupted night of sleep. My Sleep Number setting is an 85. Carla's is 65. You're going to love it. Go out and get one. It's just the best. Make quality sleep a priority this year and now save up to $1,000 on the new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed. Plus special financing for a limited time only at Sleep Number stores or sleepnumber.com/TMOS. Just make sure they know that Mike O'Mara sent you. I would appreciate that, and I love mine. I love, love, love mine. We have the Split King, by the way. And
yes.
Mrs. O'Mara never rises up in her bed. It's got the little platform that lifts your head up.
Yeah.
Mrs. O'Mara never lifts hers up.
Oh,
she's
really?
Had it. The mechanism must be absolutely pristine. Mr. O'Mara, on the other hand, up, down, up, down, up, down. Because really, I'm practicing, because what is it essentially? It's a hospital bed.
Yeah, but it's at home.
What it, is.
It seems so relaxing.
Yeah,
well,
so much better.
I don't want to strain my neck. What am I going to... Why should I build my head up with pillows, you know, to watch Night Stalker on Netflix when, you know, when
you
I don't
the
need
push
to.
Of a button.
Yeah, it's, exactly.
I mean, I just go like that. And the best part is when you are tired and when it's time to turn the light out, you just go and you're like going down. And by the way, my process when I'm finally deciding to go to sleep, it's really, well, if you saw President Trump leave today on Marine One, it's about the same as the pilots that are preparing that helicopter to leave. I'm getting equipment put in place. I'm putting my mask on. I'm reaching over.
And doesn't Carlo your bed sit on three concrete pads?
Yes, it does. Yeah, and I spool up as I'm getting ready to do that. I spool up that. And I will tell you that the bed itself is so super comfy. But the only problem I have is next to my bed, what do they call it? A nightstand.
It's a nightstand.
I always hated that name. Nightstand.
Nightstand.
Table. It's a drawer. It's a set of drawers next to your bed.
Why are you attacking big furniture? It's a nightstand.
Nightstand. Fine.
Yes.
You know,
yeah.
With some discolored wood on the top where the water from my CPAP machine is.
Yes, this is common.
Leaked out
this
a
is a common thing.
That never happened with the milk crates.
So the one thing, I got a lamp over here, all right? And a very simple lamp. that you reach up to the lamp and you twist it and it turns on and off, right? You know, okay. Lamps like that.
Yeah, sure.
Mrs. O'Mara has a propensity for purchasing foo-foo lamps, little she-she foo-foo lamps. And all of these lamps in our house, because she likes them that way, have the mechanism that's on the cord. Well, screw that. I like right. my lamps to have a twist
switch.
Up on the top, not on the cord.
No, the cord, yeah, you got to bend inevitably, down, find it.
Right.
So yes, is it a step you. Thing yeah. on the cord, or is it the wheel?
It's the wheel.
I hate the wheel. Yeah. I
the
hate
wheel.
The wheel
sucks. The no. wheel sucks.
You got to find
yeah.
it.
Ideally, so you know what I track, love? I like the chain. Yeah. I like a chain. A cha-chunk chain.
See, now you're going back to the Andy Griffith Show again.
No, but that's chain? Great. That's fantastic.
The chain?
Who still has a chain?
Thomas, what are you going to, Thomas Edison's house? The chain?
But you see, even the turning thing, the turning switch can be a little hideous sometimes.
It can be, because sometimes it's on the wrong side of the
exactly.
lamp.
Exactly. The chain you can always
pain
grab.
In the ass.
It's a pain in the ass.
But the process for me going to bed now would be lower the Sleep Number platform. And that's the best part, because it's like... my body is being moved with a mechanism, which
yes.
is
right.
really what I always crave. You know, I shouldn't
it's
say
doing
that,
the work you know, for you.
It's yeah. doing the work for me. Then, quietly, because she's always asleep before me.
Careful.
Out like a light.
Be very
is the
careful.
Click, click. Yep, the boss is always asleep before me. I reach over, get the mask, our mask on, mm-hmm. press the button, and then the process of...
Getting
the lamp.
Yeah.
Turning the lamp off.
You got a hose on you. Yeah. You got a lamp. Oh, it's the whole
it
thing.
It sucks.
I know
I really would
need,
love
Mike.
To. I, you know what I would like? I would like to have the option of not being addicted to my breathing apparatus for sleep.
May I give
especially
you,
now that I've lost some weight. I would like to be able to just go into any bed. But when I go
crazy.
To any bed and I sleep without my machine,
yeah.
you know what I wake up? I wake up like knives have
been
stuck in my
have you thought about another surgery to get that little machine inside of you that does what
no,
the CPAP
No, because
does.
I worry that if they do a surgery like that, I will come into the show the following day and I will sound like Brian Williams.
Okay.
Well, and it won't be an impression. It'll be just me. Mike, how was the process?
It didn't work out as well as I expected. Didn't really work out too well. I'm very sorry. I'm terribly sorry with that.
We're keeping tabs on the processes that are going on in Washington, but really right now they're all at church. So, you know, to the best of my knowledge, God has not struck the building with lightning yet. So
that means they're not listening live to us?
They're not listening live. And by the way, welcome to the Biden. We know we have some very serious TMOS fans within that administration. Welcome to the Mike O'Mara Show.
Yes.
Hope
yes.
you enjoy it every single day, everybody. By the way, that was a Donald Trump-style lie. To the best of my knowledge, I know no one in that incoming administration that listens to our show. We'll be right back, everybody, with news you may not need. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by our bonus package. That is the great glass elevator flew over Dusseldorf.
Yes.
Mr. Wonka turned to Charlie and said... Don't forget what happened to the man who suddenly got everything he wanted. Charlie Bucket asked, what happened? Mr. Wonka smiled and said, he lived happily ever after, Charlie.
Yes.
So if you don't want to be happy for the rest of your life, you're going to need to get everything you've ever wanted. And the TMOS bonus package is a great place to start. An extra hour of uncensored, free-form, commercial-free TMOS fun every week. Yes, please. You know it, you want it, you need it for your happiness, and it won't cost you a fortune in fudge. For pennies a day. Are you are you smoking weed?
No.
Are you smoking weed? This promo, it's like you're getting super creative. It's almost like you dropped acid when you wrote the promo.
No, I'm trying to open up doors. I'm trying to go in new directions.
It's exciting.
Yes.
You know what? And don't I tell you to do that all the time? So I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. MikeOMaraShow.com. What can take tomorrow, dip it in a dream, separate the sorrow, and collect up all the cream? The Bonus Show can.
The Bonus
Jesus
Show can.
Christ. What the hell is wrong with him? I don't know.
News.
Something's wrong with Rob.
Boo. Got my box cutter.
Wrong with Rob today.
Got my box cutter.
Jesus Christ. Do you have any other stuff you want to share in your drawer?
Yeah, what's in your box?
Before we start the news?
Got a box of chalk.
From what era?
Why?
Because I have a little blackboard sometimes that I put out at Christmas time. It's got Santa Claus on it. Got to have chalk for that. What I have a lot of, I was surprised to look in, is I've got a lot of florist wire.
What's that?
Some what? Florist wire?
I've got three spools of it.
What's florist wire for?
Little green wire. For one thing, I use it to anchor my Christmas tree against the wall because my Christmas tree fell over once. So I've probably bought too much of it. Yeah. But also, it can be used for small repairs because it's, you know, like it's a mild little wire.
What do you fix with?
Anything. If you have a tear.
Well, nice to see you got a box cutter, chalk, and some wire to tie things up. It's like a drawer that belongs to a serial killer.
Have a dreidel.
And a dreidel.
That's very nice. Flashlight. Need that sometimes.
Yeah, especially when you're night stalking.
Oh, a beautiful Bic lighter. Very, very efficient.
To burn your victims?
Well, I can't use it right-handed because I still have the sore thumb, but I can left-handed do it.
Oh, still, that thumb is still bothering you?
Yeah, it's still a little bit messed up. I've got some poker chips, a couple razor blades. Here's a token to Chuck E. Cheese.
All right. Everything you have in that drawer is on a no-fly list.
This is a coin from a government that no longer exists, and it's now in an Eastern and Western type situation. There was a wall.
Part of the Soviet bloc?
No, not quite so recent as that.
All right, I'm tired of this.
Is it a Nazi coin?
Details.
What is on your golf ball?
That is a gift from Charlie Burney. That is a Donald Duck golf ball.
That's
a limited edition Donald
Duck
golf
ball. Very, very nice.
A survivalist lighter that if you fill with lighter fluid, you can open it up and then you strike it right here. And it sparks, but it won't light because I got no lighter fluid in it.
Can I ask you a question?
I wish you would.
For that little lighter that's for survivalists.
Yeah.
Where would you ever use that?
Well, I mean, let's say the world is ending and you want to smoke.
Very good. Okay,
you borrow a cigarette and you get it. Hey, look, here's air pump needles, Mike.
All right, Robb, I got to start the news. Thank you very much.
Okay, if you must, if you must.
We're all praying for a peaceful transfer of power today. One thing we can almost guarantee is that there will be a peaceful transfer of Twitter power.
Yes.
And here's how that happens. There are 5 accounts that have to be transferred at White House, at POTUS, at VP, at FLOTUS, and at PressSec. Once Joe Biden is sworn in, the current accounts are transferred to the National Archives and Records Administration, where the tweets will be archived for public access. Wow.
Perfect.
Once that happens, can you imagine if you took a class in Trump tweets?
No.
40 years Jesus. Down the road. They're transferred to the Biden administration. Some accounts the Biden team are already using will be transferred to the new ones. For instance, at Transition 46 will become at White House, and at President-elect Biden will become at POTUS.
Okay.
And a brand new account called at Second Gentleman is being created for Kamala Harris's husband, Duck Emhoff. By the way, none of these accounts keep their followers. So if you're one of the 33.3 million people who follow POTUS, you'll have to refollow it tomorrow after Biden becomes president. If you want to keep following it, that is. Well, I follow President Trump,
yeah,
so
sure.
I'll have to do that. This will be history's second Twitter handoff. The first was from the Obama administration to the Trump administration in 2017. And how did that go? anywho, so there you
so
have
Melania
it.
So Melania will get her own new account, right?
And that's not what I wanted to play. What's that?
Melania will get her own new account so she can start plagiarizing anew starting tomorrow.
There we are. Thank you very much.
There's a lot of talk about what President Trump will do as a private citizen, but he may not be done with politics. The Wall Street Journal claims Trump has been talking to people in his inner circle about launching a new political party. Sources say he's thinking about calling it the Patriot Party. Trump hasn't commented. Trump has had issues with the Republican Party over the years, especially of late when he's blamed the party for not finding a way to let him win the election. But while a third party could become powerful with its influence, it would seemingly come at the expense of the Republican Party. Of course, it's hard to say how popular this new party would be. This week, Trump had a 34% approval rating, which makes him the least popular president Gallup has ever polled. And Melania Trump's 42% favorability rating is the worst for any first lady at the end of her term in polling history. It is also possible that Trump was just joking around or was floating this idea to threaten Republicans. So
I think he's confused because the person he wants to run the Patriot Party is Bill Belichick.
Bill Belichick would rock. Thanks a lot.
The Patriots.
Here we are. I got a whole big cheese story. I might save that for tomorrow's show.
And big cheese.
We'll get Maddie Masiello to come in and talk about cheese. That would be fun, wouldn't it, Maddie? Would you enjoy that?
So much.
There we are. It's pretty common to be worried about getting old.
Yeah.
But maybe, just maybe, it's not all that bad. According to a new survey of 2,000 grandparents, 81% of them say getting old isn't nearly as bad as they thought it would be when they were younger. Plus, there's no rule that you have to stop doing the things you like when you get older, except maybe running. 43% of the people in the survey say they still try to live their lives just like they did when they were younger. Well, I can't say I do that. No, I'd kill myself if I was doing that.
Sure.
And 45% say they're more carefree now than they used to be. No, I break a lot of these molds. I am not in this category.
I'm more carefree just because I can't remember anything.
3 out of 4 say they're nothing like their grandparents were at that age. Well, that's true.
Yeah.
My grandmother on my mother's side was old before her time. Like in the 50s, yeah. She was an old lady. That's it. But I'm not carefree because, well, I'm at my second rodeo as far as child development. Yes, sirree. Hi, 7-year-old. How you doing? Don't touch the box cutter. We're all sick and tired of reboots, remakes, and sequels until we hear about one that sounds really cool, like this one. I do like it. Apparently, yeah. There is a chance that Liam Neeson could star in a remake of The Naked Gun.
Oh, yes.
I'm laughing just at the idea. Yeah, right? It sounds good.
Wow.
There's nothing in the works right now, but Family Guy creators. Oh.
Oh.
I didn't read ahead.
Mike, you ruined everything.
Seth MacFarlane.
Of course.
Has asked him if he's interested. Well, he might write a good screenplay. I don't know. Liam says, quote, I could either finish my career or bring it in another direction. Honestly, don't know. It could either finish my career. Liam has already worked in with Seth several times on the movies A Million Ways to Die in the West. I saw that. He was good in that.
Mm-hmm.
Ted 2 and Family Guy. All right, so Liam Neeson has a great sense of humor, and he's funny when he plays the heavy. So yeah. We'll see.
Well, he has a very certain set of skills.
I have a very particular set of skills. I will find you, and I will kill you. I will. Thank you. Hit the swoosh sound. And now a little something-something. 47-year-old Daniel Wright was arrested in Utah over the weekend for impersonating an officer, and he also stole something that cops are known to enjoy. He walked into a 7-Eleven on Sunday wearing a jacket that said Sheriff's Deputy.
Nice.
And an employee called the real cops after Daniel decided to steal a donut. There you go. Police checked the security footage and tracked his white Ford pickup truck to a nearby motel where they arrested him along with a woman he was with. It turned out the truck was stolen, and they linked Daniel to another guy they arrested a day earlier after he tried to hide by burying himself in manure. It's a winning group.
Wow.
Here. They're both facing charges for burglary and racketeering, and Daniel is facing additional charges for impersonating an officer and theft of one donut. How do they track him, you ask? Well, the powdered sugar, of course. They followed it, of course. Ah, it's a clinker. We will come back with the audio vault on this inauguration day, January 20th, 2021. We'll be right back, everybody. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Noom. People love to offer advice about the best way to eat, and it's never any good. That's right. Why I love Noom. They know what they're doing. Based in psychology, Noom teaches you how to eat because you don't need rules to lose weight. You need knowledge. Noom personalizes a weight loss program just for you, and it's only 10 minutes a day. Plus, Noom is flexible, empathetic, easy, and forgiving. They know you're only human. If you stumble, you get back on track, and you do it tomorrow. It works. Don't believe me? Over 80% of Noomers finished the program, and over 60% have stuck with their goals for at least a year. Oscar loves Noom. Mm-hmm. Carla has never looked better. There is a science to getting healthier. It's called Noom. Sign up for your trial today at Noom, Noom.com/TMOS. Learn how to eat again with Noom. Sign up for your trial today at Noom. That's Noom.com/TMOS. Ready to learn how to live healthier? Sign up for Noom today at Noom, Noom.com/TMOS. And we thank you. Let's open up the audio Radio Vault on this Inauguration Day. Take it away, Robb.
Mike, I don't think you need to focus so much on your career on Cameo, because Cameo has really dropped yet another notch in my estimation.
Really?
You know, yes, for $80 now, you can get a Cameo video, and you're familiar with Cameo, right? It's where you pay a set fee, and a celebrity will send a greeting either to yourself.
I tried on two separate occasions to join Cameo, and they never got back to me.
Really?
You send in the request to be, and they mucked it twice, and I went to hell with it. It's not fun.
Well, Mike, for $80, now you can get a Cameo greeting from Punxsutawney Phil, the groundhog from Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania. And what it is, it's the disinterested handler holding Phil. And, of course, he's wearing the top hat because he's a jackass. And he does the talking while he's holding a disinterested rodent. And here goes like this.
B-Rad. We've got Punxsutawney Phil here, and I'm his handler, the Rainmaker. This is from your buddy Chaz. We understand you work in a hospital, and it's been a pretty tough year. On the bright side, I'm assuming you've got the vaccine.
Oh,
so you got
you.
That
no,
you,
not Phil. Not fair. Not fair, because you because you feed a rodent, you
yeah,
get to
rat.
Go in and do a cameo. That, but if you want Punxsutawney Phil... I'm sorry. I have my apologies to you, because if you're out there and it's been a tough year for you, God, I hate people.
Raise your bar, is that what I say?
Yeah,
really?
I agree.
Come on. You know, my brother-in-law got Jerry Remy of the Boston Red Sox, the color commentary guy.
Really?
That was a big one.
How
yeah,
much?
That was a good one. I forgot how much it cost, but it was he's on there, you know?
Yeah.
And I do it. I was ready to do it. I could use always a little supplement, you know, for the intergovernment,
sure.
But it sucks. It really, I mean, I tried to get on there. It's now why are you smirking?
I can help get you on. I just think you're going to hate it because you don't like being told what to do.
What do you mean? Well, how would I be told what to do? Somebody wants me to
well,
give a greeting to somebody?
Sometimes.
Very specific.
What do you mean
request?
They're very specific?
Like you would get a message that says, I need you to do Charlie, and this is the message you have to give me, and you are rated in how quickly you do it. So if you're a late responder, then you're like, you're a bad
cameoer.
Bad cameoer.
And can I send back no thank you?
Oh, no.
No, that'll destroy your rating.
Yeah, destroy your rating.
Yeah.
Like, you have to do it on demand quickly to be, like, one of these great cameo artists.
Like the groundhog.
All right, I'll get back to you on that.
All right, thank you. See, Mike, there are good animals out there, like Tico the parrot. Tico the parrot has a YouTube page, and what happens is his owner plays songs, classic rock songs on the guitar, and Tico sings along. Tico does a pretty good Stairway to Heaven.
Perfect pitch.
Good pitch, right?
That's friggin' hysterical. But he's not doing it. I mean, he's not doing anything other than going, yeah.
But his pitch is good. I didn't make it through Patience by Guns N' Roses. Also, I didn't like the fact that the guy who runs the YouTube page spelled it Patience like hospital patients. So he's not really into it.
Okay. I get it. I get it.
So let's say the wife dents the car and she needs a creative way to tell her husband so he doesn't get mad at her. This was going viral yesterday. This wife has a pretty good technique.
Hey, so remember when I was pregnant, you told everyone we're pregnant?
Yeah.
And remember when I gave birth, you told everyone we gave birth?
Yeah.
Well, we dented the car.
So we dented the car.
We dented the car.
Do you remember last November when
By the way, I hate a guy that says we're pregnant.
Oh, I know.
I hate that.
No.
Yeah. Unless
she's
unless he's carrying the child.
Right. Which, I don't think they've mastered that technology yet.
Not yet.
Mike, last November, I spotlighted the Just Scream hotline because people with the election and the pandemic that were at the end of their rope could just call a hotline and scream. Right?
Right.
The number was 561-567-8431. The reason I say that is because today is the last day for the Just Scream hotline. So if you want to get your scream in, you got to do it today. He got over 70,000 screams, and he has posted them all, and they will remain available for download should you need them. Here's one of his montages. Actually, I'm sorry. That's the audio
water
of Donald
all over
Trump.
Myself here.
That's Donald Trump right before he left on Marine One. I apologize.
No, he's mellow today. He was chill.
Yeah.
He was chill, Donald today.
Xanax.
Very chill.
Yeah. All right. Allegedly. And let us close with this, Mike. It is not only Inauguration Day, perhaps more importantly, it is National DJ Day.
And, hey, it's DJ Day.
And the disc jockey actually dates its career back to 1909 when a 16-year-old guy named Ray Newby, who was at the Herald College of Engineering in San Jose, was the first person to use wireless technology to play a record. It's the first time it happened in 1909. 25 years later, in 1934, famous radio guy Walter Winchell coined the term disc jockey. And I have, this is not in 1909, but it's around that same time. This is one of the first DJs that I have tape of.
Right now, with me in the studio, I have Mr. Mike O'Meara, our weather expert.
Al, the situation is basically this. There has been a low-pressure system which has regurgitated around a low-pressure high that has been causing all of this misty weather that we've been having. When you get two fronts in this type of hyperstructural systemation, you will have a situation where the misty, mystifiable pronunciation of the high will cause this controversial situation in the weather patterns among the northeastern Gulf Stream water fronts. And that will cause the overall fluctuation of the cloud structure, which will, as most people know, cause an indentation into the major reciprocation of the cloud or cloudal front. I think many people today aren't really
Wenzel?
Into weather. I'm into it in a big way.
Yes. Certainly, what if you woke up one morning and there was no weather?
Yeah, exactly. And I've said that to my mother and my father. I said, look, you know, we get up in the morning, we see the sun, but what if there wasn't anything? What if there was Zippo? You know, we wouldn't
Indeed.
Have weather. Weather is life, Al. That's what we all revolve around.
That's
Thank
right.
you very much, Mike.
That's WAMU 1981, the Wenzel and O'Meara Show. Happy
That's
National
That's better than
Disc
some of the stuff
Day.
I did early in my career on WABA.
That's your magic.
I'm proud
radio
of that
mom.
One. That's good. That's a baby DJ. I'm a teeny bopper there. That's fantastic.
Have a good Wednesday, everybody.
That's
Great
awesome.
Job.
Wenzel, thanks for sharing that.
I think I. There we are.
There we are.
There it is.
That was open.
Open.
No, it's closed.
Oh.
I think it's cracked. Slam it one more time. Thank you.
Does that make you happy?
Very happy. A,
hey, thank you, Alan Wenzel. Way to go. I love that. We got to get out of here. Enjoy your inaugural festivities today. And for the people that are pissed off, watch the inauguration. It helped me, believe it or not. It actually helped me. And watch the president-elect's speech and the president's speech today. The new president. Here's to President Joe Biden. Well done. Woo. And we will see you tomorrow with our impressions of how the day went. Hopefully a peaceful day. We'll see you for Robb Spiewak and Oscar Santana. Mike O'Meara saying so long, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Before you go, please make a mental note. Today's show is made possible by the TMOS bonus packages. You can secure yours right now by going to MikeO'MearaShow.com and clicking on the red bonus banner. Buy it or give it. Either way, you're helping out TMOS, and that's a good thing. Thank you, and go in peace.
Mike O'Meara, Radio Entertainment.
It's a whole hoax, and you know who's playing into the hoax? People like you.
See, there's a typical fake news deal. You're so disgraceful. And you should say congratulations, great job, instead of being so horrid.
Don't be rude.
I say that you're a terrible reporter. That's what I say.
You rudely interrupted him.
And you should be thanking them for what they've done, not always asking wise guy questions.
You will never make it. You know you're a fake. You know that.
You are the enemy of the people.
You're a very rude person. The way you treat other people are horrible. You shouldn't treat people that way. You are a rude, terrible person.
And you should say thank you very much for good judgment. Sit down. I didn't call you.
Well, you don't know what you have. What's happened there is a disgrace.
I think it's a disgrace. And I say that. And that's something that Nazi Germany would have done and did do.
Don't be rude. Your organization's terrible.
Quiet.
If you keep talking, I'll leave and you can have it out with the rest of these people.
If they don't like it here, they can leave.
I don't know who's going to miss them, but I guess some people will.
Where I have the right to do whatever I want as president, but I don't even talk about that. Where I have the right to do whatever I want as...
That was unnecessary. It should have never happened.
And I think it's a very bad signal that you're putting out to the American people.
Look, let me tell you something. Be nice.
You know it, and I know it, and they know it.
Then I see the disinfectant that knocks it out. And is there a way we can do something like that? By injection.
Wait.
I know who you are. Just wait. Quiet. 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 Quiet.